Indiana Jones is one of the most famous fictional Tomb Raiders in the world. Steven Spielberg and George Lucas created the character to be like James Bond, but without the gadgets, and used history and mythology to make the films entertaining. Roy Chapman Andrews was famed for his adventures in the Gobi Desert and Mongolia. He was an American archaeologist in the 1920s and brought the first fossilized dinosaur eggs to the American Museum of Natural History. To add drama to the film, the filmmakers added many booby traps to the tombs, such as spikes from the walls, shooting arrows, pits to fall into, tons of spikes. Many of these traps were included in the 1996 video game Tomb Raider, featuring Lara Croft. The most famous and iconic booby trap was the giant rolling boulder that can flatten your seconds. As entertaining as these traps are, no tombs have ever been discovered protected by booby traps. The Chachaboyas, seen near the beginning of Raiders of the Lost Ark, were really a tribe from Peru between 900 AD and 1470 AD, but they had not been guarding any temples in the 1930s, as the tribe was defeated by the Incas and their culture ended in the 18th century. After Indy returns from Peru, he is visited by two men from the US Army intelligence, explaining they have intercepted radio communication from the Nazis in Cairo about a lost city called Tanis and the Ark of the Covenant. Unlike the film, the city of Tanis was not buried in a sandstorm, and it never was home to the Ark of the Covenant, but it was still an important archaeological site. In 1939, Pierre Montet, a French archaeologist, uncovered the city where the Nile once was and inside. He found a royal tomb containing Sheshonq I, as well as golden bracelets, amulets, statues, and sarcophagi. As the film was set in 1936, just before the World War II, having the Nazis as the bad guys was a good choice. But would they really be interested in ancient relics? Shockingly, the answer would be yes. In 1935, the leader of the SS, Heinrich Himmler, made a special division of the SS called the Annalerbach, for their own expeditions to search for history and evidence to support their claims of German being from an Aryan or master race. Himmler was a big believer in the occult and thought that he could use ancient artifacts like the Ark of the Covenant as a weapon of war. The mythology of the Ark of the Covenant has been recorded in the Bible and the Quran, and just like the film, it is said to have the power of God. The Bible tells how the walls of Jericho crashed to the ground and how hundreds of people died just by looking at the Ark, which is why Indy would not look at it when the Germans used it. There are lots of stories of where the Ark of the Covenant is today. Some say it's buried under the ruins of the King Solomon's temple. Ethiopians claim they guard it in a temple on a hillside, and it's protected by someone who takes a lifelong vow to protect it, and only that person is allowed to see it, which makes it hard to prove otherwise. The most accepted story is that the Ark was taken by the Knights Templar and moved to either France or Great Britain. Indiana Jones is back in cinemas this summer on the 30th of June, called Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny. I highly recommend you see it.